Busch Gardens Williamsburg, 8 coasters, tons of scenery, and absolutely a great time. Today, I'm going to be telling you how to ride all the coasters at Busch Gardens Williamsburg and get all the credits. Before this video begins, if you guys enjoy my content, then please consider subscribing. We are about 5 subscribers away from 100, so getting 100 within the next few days would really help me out, and it would be really cool to hit that milestone. Now let's just get into the video now. The first thing I want to mention in this guide is about early entry. Early entry is on weekends of July and August, and it provides pass holders early entry from 9 to 10 in certain areas of the park, mostly Scotland, Ireland, and of course England, where everybody can be before the park opens. My first tip to do would be going into Scotland. That means going past England, and then by the time you get to the Scotland stables, they will check for your pass, and you will show it to them, and then you're good to go. I would suggest going straight to Loch Ness Monster. This ride can have some pretty brutal waits throughout the day, so I would say knock it out during early entry and get it early. If you get early entry on it, then chances are it will be a walk-on. And you know what? Just for the heck of it, do a second ride. Loch Ness is a great ride, and you don't know how long it's going to be there for. One thing I advise, though, is that the area with Tempesto and Apollo's Chariot doesn't open until 10:15, so those rides don't open until 10:15. So you will have a bit of time to kill if you did ride Loch Ness Monster. So if you have the time, just do Finnegan's Flyer and then go over to that area of the park. If you are a non-pass holder and you can't get early entry, here's what you do. You get into the parking lot by 9 or 9:15, get into the park by about 9:40, and then go straight over to the section with Apollo's Chariot and Tempesto. It will again be closed up until 10:15, but you won't be able to ride anything anyways, so getting an early jump on Tempesto and Apollo's Chariot when they open is going to be a really good thing. It again follows the same path as if you were a member or not a member. So now the two sides converge, and now we're going to be talking about them in the same way. The only difference with the non-member is that they didn't ride Loch Ness Monster or Finnegan's Flyer. Hopefully both members and non-members can be in the line for Tempesto and Apollo's Chariot, waiting for that area of the park to open by 10:15. And when the clock strikes 10:15, go to Tempesto. I don't care if you go to Apollo, it may be smart, but honestly, I prefer doing Tempesto first. You know why? Tempesto can have some brutal waits just like Loch Ness Monster throughout the day, only because of its one train operations. So I would just say to make sure you can get a ride on it, hit it first, and you'll likely be the first train of the day. Once you get off Tempesto, I would highly suggest going to Apollo now. I've been highly surprised to see Apollo is only a 5-minute wait once I get off Tempesto, as most people are actually still in the front of the park waiting to actually get in. After you get off Apollo's Chariot, head to Verbolten. I know it may be a little narrow paths, and it might be hard to find, but it's pretty easy once you study the map. After going into the Black Forest, go over to Alpengeist. Chances are it will be a walk-on to 10 minutes, so you can get a nice ride on this great B&M Invert. After Alpengeist, I would say head over to Invader. This will probably be the longest line of the day if you follow my tips, and it's a decently busy day, but not super busy. Invader normally gets about 15 to 20 minute lines at the time of the day that you should be at, so it won't be terrible. But again, it is a bit of waiting. And after Invader, I would say book it to Griffin. By now, Griffin's about a 20 to 30 minute wait, so you should have no trouble getting on the ride. Sometimes Griffin does open at 12 for some reason, and if it opens at 12, and if you get to the blind by 11:30, I would highly suggest waiting the 30 minutes, and then you'll be the first train of the day, hopefully, if you waited it out. And by now, you should have all the credits. Oh wait, did I forget something? The non-members have not ridden Loch Ness Monster yet, and you haven't even ridden the kiddie coaster, the best ride in the park, of course. So now you're going to ride that. First of all, I want to say do the kiddie coaster first, because Loch Ness can have atrocious waits. And after doing Air Grover, head over to Loch Ness. I know the wait time will be over 60 minutes, but you've gotten a lot of credits by now, hopefully, with now waiting long. So you might have to just suck it up for this long wait time of the day, and then you'll be completely done. And if you're a member, then you obviously already rode Loch Ness, so you're done. So congratulations on getting the credits. Now for the non-members, enjoy your wait time. Anyways, that's going to be it for today's video. If you guys enjoyed, then make sure to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to get notified when I upload. I'm going back to once weekly uploads, so that one's going to be starting next week. So if you guys are ready for that, then I guess you guys have to be ready for that. But anyways, thanks for watching. See you guys and keep on riding. This is Air G Coaster signing out.